Hey, what's up guys? It's Yvonne. And in this video, I want to share with you the 5 specific things you should not do on Google Ads to not get instantly banned. I think some Google Ad policies are very vague. And so in this video, I want to give you something a little more specific, especially for those of you that are beginners, that are just starting out, that are asking, how do I create an account? Or how do I, once I do create an account, how do I create a campaign without getting banned? These are 5 things you should not do in your campaign to not get banned. I've been using Google Ads for the past 7 years, so I have a lot of experience with myself and my accounts, as well as other accounts that I watched, that I helped, that I consulted, things like that. And so I want to share all this with you here today in this video. Are you ready? Let's get straight into it. The first thing you should not do with Google Ads that will get you insta-banned is putting in the name of the company in your ad and saying you're official. So here's an example, buy, research, official website. The older your account is, the longer it will take for you to get banned. But if you're a brand new account that says something like this, you'll get insta-banned, pretty much guaranteed. Okay, so don't put in the name of the company, say you're official, use the trademark symbols, the copyright symbols. Don't do that, right? Here's another one. I think it's buy live pure, buy life pure, you know, something like that. Okay, I had to look for some products because I'm in a different country, so some of the ads don't show in my country. But here's another example, buy Exapure, right? So this is okay, you know, Exapure buy now, Exapure special offer, although the TM there is dangerous. Okay, something like that could get you banned. If not right now, tomorrow. All right, Exapure official, you know, official website. Boom, that is dangerous. Unless this is actually Exapure promoting, which I don't believe so, because the website is click here for offers.online. This could get you banned right away, especially for you beginners. Don't do that. Okay, that falls under the misrepresentation policy, which could get your whole account banned right away. Okay. The second thing you should not do with Google Ads, especially if you're just starting out, if you have a new account, is use the tracking template. So Google Ads, you know, this is an example of an ad. Most, I believe all ad formats have the tracking template. And if you scroll down to add URL options, you have the tracking template here. What this is basically a tracking link. So what this allows you to do is to put the final URL of your site here, let's say yvonnemana.com. But let's suppose I'm using a third-party tool like ClickMagic, Volume, Beemob to track, right, how many people click there, without having to add a code to the site. This is especially useful for affiliates. If you don't have control of the page, you can't put your code, then you use tracking link. So with the tracking link, it basically redirects legally, right? By legally, I mean within Google policies. This is okay to redirect if you put a tracking link here, because people, when they click on your ad, they don't actually see this URL. They don't go through this. This is just for Google. But there seems to be some kind of issue with Google Ads and some trackers, or not even trackers, just Bitly. If you create a brand new account, you go to Bitly and you shorten your link and you put it here, you can get insta-banned. I've seen it happen. I've had it happen. Don't do that. What you should do instead, if you do want to track, is use redirectless tracking. So companies, again, like ClickMagic, Beemob, Volume, they all have that. And what they do is they put a code on your site, and then you can just basically put your site here with that tracking code. And that way you'll be able to track. So whenever you can, if you guys are beginners, try to use this redirectless tracking. With ClickMagic, it's called ClickMagic Campaigns. With Volume, Beemob, it's called, I think, redirectless tracking or something like that. And just don't use a tracking link when you're starting out. I know it seems weird because Google does give you the option, but for some reason, your account, they just don't like it. They think that you're an affiliate, which you probably are, and they just don't like affiliates, and they just ban you right away, okay? So just be careful with that. The third thing that you should definitely not do with Google Ads is to direct link to some offers. Even if you can get some nice pretty link and you can put the link in the URL, let's suppose, I don't know, like if we talk about research or Exapure, right? You can be like exapure.com/Yvonne, right? Let's suppose you get that affiliate link, you put it in here. Don't do that. That could get you insta-banned. Here's why. Google keeps track of all the different domains and websites and links and whatever that go through Google Ads. So if somebody got banned on Google Ads before using that URL and now you're putting it in, your chances to get banned are higher because Google Ad thinks that you're that same person that got banned before. and they think you're trying to create a new account with that same URL. So don't do that. Build a landing page or a website, and I'll get into landing pages later on, but have your own content. Don't just direct link because it could be dangerous. Again, I've seen it happen, had it happen. If you're a beginner, don't do that. It's risky. It's dangerous. At least have a very established account that Google trusts, you know, then you can maybe experiment, but I don't recommend it either way. Tip number four, cloaking. Do not cloak. Horrible thing, okay? You have no idea how many people I have asking me,
Ivan, how do I cloak? Teach me how to cloak.
And I think the reason for that is a few years ago, 5 years ago, some tracking companies used cloaking as a kind of name for the tracking link. They didn't mean actually cloaking. They meant cloaking as in, here is a tracking link. That's what it is. And cloaking means we're not gonna show people what your affiliate link is. Okay, so right now what cloaking means is literally deceiving Google. Showing to Google one link, let's say ivanmena.com, but taking people to a whole other link. Don't cloak, because that just, you're just lying to Google. That will instantly get you banned. If not instantly, then in a day, in 2 days, okay? Google will find out. So that's tip number four. Now, my advice to you, number five, for Google Ads and for what you should avoid is some niches, okay? So here I have a list: adult content, alcohol, gambling and games, healthcare and medicines. This does not mean weight loss pills, okay? That's not what this means. Political content, financial services, and travel. Now, these ones are listed on the Google site that you should avoid. For these categories, Google is very, very strict because they know that there's a lot of addiction for these products, right? For gambling, people are addicted. Alcohol, people are addicted. You know, healthcare and medicines, people need it. People need to have it to live sometimes. Financial services, you know, some people need money to live. Otherwise, they won't have money for whatever it is they actually need to survive or something like that, right? So they are very, very strict. So for example, here's a site, you know, financial regulations for some countries. If you want to promote, for example, in Australia, you need to send them this document, I believe. And that's what it is. Must complete a verification process. Yeah. So you're going to complete a verification process, a whole process to promote in some of these niches. This isn't just finance. This is just an example, right? For healthcare, gambling, especially, you know, you will need all these documents. You will need a verification. So if you're just starting out, you know, don't put those ads because you do need to go through the verification process. Brazil, you know, here's all you need for Brazil. Look at all that. You need like 8 supporting documents. Holy shit, guys, right? So stay away from these. Now, one of them that's not listed is travel, and they should list it because look at this post. And I've seen it happen. I've had it happen myself. I've seen it happen as well, where travel campaigns just get instantly suspended. And it makes no sense, to be honest, because this link here, let me know in the comments if you want me to add this link. I'll add it like as a comment if you guys want. But you can just look this up. Travel campaign got suspended on Google support. And this site's pretty good. I will show you in a second. But this guy says, you know, travel agencies are actively scrutinized by Google. Okay, so that means very strict. Your site has no transparency in pricing. It will not be unsuspended. Like, come on, seriously? This is a bullshit reply. I'll be honest. I just want to reply here and I can't because it's locked. Like, dude, give some good feedback. This is just such bullshit. This guy's like, yeah, it will not be unsuspended. Yeah, this is just ridiculous. But basically, this guy has a legit site, and you know, people are complaining that like, hey, if this is legitimate, why, like, what the f-? You know, but Google is very strict in some categories, so I'm just warning you. I don't agree with them whatsoever. Like, if you look at this site, what I wanted to show you, TripAmigo, this guy says your site has no transparency in pricing. But if you look at this, if you put anything in, let's say Toronto to Medellin, you put in some dates, of course this is in Spanish because I'm in a Spanish speaking country, but if you put this in, this is pretty transparent to pricing. It's like a regular, normal, standard site. Look, it tells you the pricing, it tells you everything, right? So it's pretty standard. Now, granted, he might have changed it, but honestly, I don't doubt that this is the way it was at the beginning. I have no doubts that this is how it was. And the person who responded, Moshi, he just kind of looked at the front page and he's like, oh, well, it must have been suspended for something. Let me find a reason. Let me pull a reason out of my ass, which is what he did. And that's what happened. So point is, avoid these sites. I don't agree with Google whatsoever, but don't promote in these if you're just starting out. Let your account warm up for a few months, a few years even, before you even attempt to submit the documents for these. As for travel, I don't even know what they need, because if a site like this can get banned, I don't know what to tell you. You know, you might need a full-on like actual site. Oh, and then look at this reply too. It says, Google doesn't like this type of travel site because often to make a booking phone call is required, which in the modern era is suspicious. Why would it be suspicious to make a phone call? That's so weird. Also, if the client is offering flights that can be booked online, then they can't be cheaper than the big booking companies, and they can't afford to compete with the big booking companies unless somehow they, like, what the fuck are you talking about? You know, this is just so weird. This isn't good for the searcher. What? You can't have a lower price than big competitors? Like, some of these replies just make no sense. But just take my advice and just avoid these altogether until Google gets their shit together, or until something happens, or until, I don't know, some changes. But that's my advice to you guys. In the next video, I do want to go over the 5 rumors about Google Ads and suspensions, because there's a lot of incorrect information being thrown around as well, and I want to address those and shed some light on what the right thing is, okay? So thanks for watching this video. If you enjoyed this content, guys, take a look at my website at yvonmanna.com. I have lots of training courses here where I take your hand and guide you step by step through these different paid ad networks, and of course I give you a free 55-page affiliate marketing guide, and I send you some valuable information on via email sometimes. So that is all. Thank you guys for watching. I will see you in the next video.